Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to the 31st episode of Subchoice, the series where you decide what I fly out by leaving me your requested planes in the comments below. Today we're flying out the A36 Apache requested by Mark, and we're flying it out in realistic battle to see what this plane can do. Today I did not take any bomb loads. We're gonna try to fly the plane as an interceptor attacker. The plane of course is an attacker, and you get some bomb load options which are quite nice. Or what's nice, you get three different options that with ever increasing heavy bombs. You start off with 100 pounds, then the 250 pounds, and then the 500 pounds. You get two of them, which is quite nice. But you get an attacker spawn because this plane is meant as an attacker. It is the let's say the bomb throwing version of the P-51. Very nice aircraft, designated as the A-36 Apache. The plane has some good strings which you can use with that attacker spawn. The climb rate isn't too great, so you do have to side climb a little bit, but once you get this plane up to altitude, you can make use of this plane's very good dive speed, which is excellent. It's somewhere at 845 kilometers an hour. The plane also has good armament in the form of 6 50 cals. You have 2 50 cals in the nose with 300 rounds per gun, and 4 in the wings with 350 rounds per gun. And I used universal belt in this match with a 600 meter convergence. The plane sits at a 3.0 battle rating in RB, and that is quite nice battle rating for this plane. There is a lot of planes that of course are more tuned to being a fighter. This thing is lacking in certain areas, but it can still be very nice from altitude. You gotta fly this plane very disciplined, and when you do, you can make it work in the fighter role, definitely. So like I said, very good dive speed, decent armament, and the bomb load options are also decent. The maneuverability when fast is quite surprising, but after a few turns you get slower and the maneuverability starts to suffer. This is true for most of the P-51s, and it is true for this plane as well. So you definitely gotta pick your moments when you want to make two turns, and then you gotta make sure that you either get out of the engagement or you have finished off the opponent. So this plane is not very forgiving when it comes to that. You gotta make very, very good choices, otherwise you're screwed. The plane has decent to good energy retention. It is not great in vertical maneuvers, but the energy retention in a straight line is very good. So the best thing to do when you need to escape from something is to put it into a dive and to outspeed the opponent. It is a P-51. In essence, so it can run away from lots of things, which is good. At low altitude this plane is the best. It does not perform fantastically at high altitudes. Mid to low altitude is what this plane was made for. It does have some air brakes as well, which can be quite nice if you are in a pickle and you need to go all in a dogfight. The air brakes can definitely make an enemy overshoot and give you the opportunity to get guns on target. And like I said, the attacker spawn makes the climb rate the plane has a little less bad, because if it would go off the airfield this plane, you would have some problems getting to altitude, because the climb rate is average. That is not one of this plane's strengths. It also has some control stiffening at the highest speed. And like I said, when it gets slow, you become a brick. And not very maneuverable then. And then you're a sitting duck, basically. And you need to depend on your allies in the neighborhood to get you out of that pickle. Or use the air brakes and see if you can do something marvelous. Acceleration in the dive initially also is not fantastic. But the plane does steadily pick up its speed, and once you get to the top speed, it does hold on to the speed. In this match we had some good early engagements, and we sit on 2 kills as we went back to the airfield after that pickle we were in. as you saw me escape back to the airfield, I was able to extend from two people above me who were closing in, but my energy retention in a straight line kept my speed above 500, and I ran away from them in the end. Went back and repaired, reloaded, and we found this German gunboat. As we went for the left wing there, focus burst on the engines there, and we set a fire. Now look at this fireworks. We're trying to get out of it, or not get hit by that firework, because that can be quite devastating. We already were hit by a few, and I think it were a few 50 kills, but it does go down. If you focus your beam of death on one of the engines, on one of the wings of the BV-238, you have a good chance that the plane becomes uncontrollable and will go plummeting towards the ground. If you go for the central area of the plane, the central fuselage, you don't have much chance to bring the plane down. So go for the wings on that thing. They're big enough to get a consistent burst on target. Now, three kills, as that B-34 there, the bomber, shot down several of the enemies before I got to that German gunboat. Which was quite funny, actually. And the third one who died actually didn't die close to him. He died on the airfield. And I made that guess when I killed the BV-238. As he didn't get a parachute, I figured he was on the airfield, made my way there. And indeed, the C-205 Lucas here got back into the air and was making his way back on the battlefield. He already died once, and we're gonna try to kill him again in this match. Oh, let's go into a dive. That is the best place for this thing. As you see, a steady build-up of speed, not massive. We are going into quite a steep dive, and we're picking up speed consistently as we are closing in on the C-205. He brings us back to his airfield. I don't care anymore, I want to get this game over with, and I'm gonna try to shoot him out of the sky and hopefully survive myself. I'm quite fast, 730 here, as you see. No problem for this plane. And there he goes, pilot snipe. And let's try to get the hell out of here. We have an oil leak, we are completely yellow, we already took a few hits from the AA. Oh, and that one really took me out of balance, but I managed to stabilize the plane just in time. And we make it! Yes, we survive. 4 kills, very nice. 2nd place in the team. And quite a nice performance from the A-36. Let's see what kind of rewards we got for that performance. I don't have premium anymore, it ran out. So this is with a normal account. Final blow. Terror of the Sky and Bulletproof, 80,000 Silver Lions and 1,800 Research Points for the 2nd place. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. Now that was enjoyable, but yeah, I wouldn't call this plane brilliant. It is pretty limited. It is good when it comes to from altitude, it's fast. You can use it in the boom and zoom role as a fighter, but I personally wouldn't put bombs on it. You would have to go low then. And immediately you lose one of the great benefits of this plane, which is its speed and performance in a dive. And I wouldn't want to take that away from this plane to start off with. You take a lot of options away. And yes, you might throw off 2 bombs and you might get 1 or 2 ground targets. But I believe that is not worth it in this plane. If you would want to use this plane, I would definitely use it as a fighter and try to boom and zoom with it. It is not ideal. I would use other planes before this plane, but it can do a job there, definitely. So Mark, I hope this satisfied your request. And for the rest of you and Mark as well, make sure to leave me your new request for the next episode in the comments below. I look forward to what you guys will throw at me this time. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you. see you guys next time. Bye bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.